We came out of the debate at a point where there was a direct contradiction going on between Ashok Rao Kavi and Father Dominic Emmanuel. We're handing it back to Ashok Rao Kavi, and then I have a question. After they complete, I have a question for our guest from Thiruvananthapuram. Yes, go ahead. Ashok, what was your point to Father Dominic?
I want to my point is, he always finally boils down to the church's stand. And
yeah.
He has a right to that. He's a priest.
Why not? That's why I'm here on this debate.
Yes, I am
called on this debate.
Now listen to me. Now
I am
listen,
called on this
now
debate
listen to me.
Not because I am a heterosexual. I am called on this debate not because I am a lawyer, not because I am a heterosexual or because I am an author. I am called here because I represent the church. Okay? Let's be clear
and
about
I,
that.
I am called here. Here. I am called here, Father Dominic, precisely because I am a homosexual. Okay? So let's get that straight. I'm everything
Fine, that's
that
why
you are
in
against.
The debate.
As far
no,
as
but
I'm
you're
concerned.
Saying,
yeah.
No, you are
now,
saying get out of the I don't want to hear about
listen,
Christianity.
You
I don't want to hear
me.
About church. No, don't insult. You don't
no,
insult.
I don't want to.
Because don't say I don't
no,
want to hear
I'm
about church.
No, I'm not insulting you. I'm telling
no.
you.
No, then I should get out from
I
here.
I don't want to hear.
Arnab, please decide that
then you get out. You get out.
Arnab, then please decide whether...
You can get out.
I will get out. Yeah, I will get out.
Gentlemen, Can I request both of you? Can I come in, gentlemen, between both of you? I want to say something between both of you. One second. Father, 1 minute. Father Dominic Emmanuel and Ashok Rao.
Why have you called me?
1 minute. Night after night.
Why have you called me?
1 minute. First, let me say this, please, Father. Let me here say this, Father. 1 minute to you. I say this and I do this program because I believe that the only way in our democracy to let points of view emerge for the truth to come out is not for a false consensus to be built. Is because healthy debate will lead to different points of view. And I have called you both. Let me complete. Because I respect both your... I respect your right to have your point of view. And I respect the fact that both of you are passionate about it.
Exactly.
And it's very good. I think it's good that you are passionate.
Now,
good that Rahul Ishwar is passionate.
Ashok Kavi is saying, I don't want to hear about the church. I don't want to hear about
Ashok,
the church.
Ashok, can I say something to
you,
Ashok?
You respect my
view. Ashok, can I say something to you, Ashok? Can I say something to you with respect?
Yes.
Like I respect your right.
Go on.
I strongly respect your right and Anish's right to have your point of view. I just want to say one thing to you. Let Father Dominic have his point of view. And if he's called, yes, he represents the views of the church, which is strongly against homosexuality. Let him have his point of view. I'm just saying, hear him out. Let's not... We want both of you to stay and none of you to walk out of the debate. Okay? Yeah, that's all.
That's all I'm asking.
Okay, fine. Continue. Now let's continue on the moot point.
Can I talk? Just one request from my side.
Now can I talk?
Okay, Rahul wants to add one thing before you speak. Yes, Rahul, what are you saying?
I'm a religious person. I would request... Ashok ji, one simple request. See, I speak as a modern Indian youth who believes in tradition, but yet understand things have to be evolved and changed. I respect your point of view, but having said that, see, don't attack father or anybody who has a different point of view like this. We need integration in society. We are ready to talk meaningfully to this. Let people have awareness. Let people understand. But please don't have this arrogant kind of attacking attitude.
Okay, can I say one thing?
Any purpose.
Can I say one thing?
Can I
say one thing before Ashok, before you come in? I'm saying this. We all respect religion. We are only saying religious laws are not made on religious texts. We made that point. Now let Ashok complete, please, Rahul. Let him complete. Both of you have attacked him. Let him complete.
You know why I said what I said about Cedric is, I mean Father Dominic is, if there was any other religious person, I would have said that the Delhi High Court judgment is very clear, not about public morality, not about religious morality. It is about constitutional morality. And the constitutional morality says that we have to have our rights. And as far as I'm concerned, it was well argued out. Not only that, but even the whole concept of privacy was well argued out.
Very good argument.
And that nobody has a right to invade.
It's a very good argument. I'd like to get the father and Rahul.
Please. Again, you, Arnab, let me finish. Let me finish. All I'm saying is I respect the father and I respect the father doing his masses in church. I respect Rahul Ishwar, the way he explains Hinduism and the way he explains the tradition. I really respect them both. But as far as Section 377 is concerned, Please keep your baggage outside. Look at the Constitution. The Constitution assures you that we have the right to equality within the limits of our private
the
life.
The Delhi High Court.
I am not saying that, for example, I'm very...
He throws that argument back.
I'm really upset about... Yes. No. All I'm trying to tell you is, Rahul Ishwar, I never expected you to bring in the bestiality into this. You know, I really didn't expect it.
Yeah. Ashokji, one second. The arguments regarding privacy was well argued. We respect it. It is very tough to deny the consensual sex part in the modern era. We respect it. I totally respect your passion. But I'm afraid, I have gone to a lot of discussion in many national channels. There has been some kind of a negative, a reverse stereotyping. Those who even express slight reservation or inhibition or some genuine aspect regarding this are suddenly branded anti-progressive. Really, I have seen worse religious shock.
Don't argue from the point of view of permanent bias. This argument is wrong, Rahul. Rahul, this argument is flawed.
This is a kind of chauvinism from the other side.
No, there is no...
Words in our mouth. He's putting words in our mouth. We have never said you're anti-progressive. We do not think that is an anti-progressive stand. There's a rational stand which is very worried about homosexuality. And I totally give it to you. But the fact is, whether you like it or not, you have to respect our right to be who we are. You have to give us our rights according to the Constitution.
I challenge you, Rahul. Rahul, now, 1 minute. Rahul, now, can I come in, please, gentlemen, between both of you? I'm just saying one thing between both of you.
Arnabji, one sentence.
Whoa, why I need to ask you this, Rahul? Yeah. Rahul, please, I respect you as a religious person, right? As a person associated with a certain religious trust, I respect Father Dominic. But I'm asking you, Rahul, you are a citizen of this country. The country has a constitution. What takes precedence for you?
Exactly.
The High Court's interpretation of the Indian constitution that says that people from the gay and lesbian community in India have a fundamental right to their way of life under Article 14, equality before law, Article 15, prohibition of discrimination, Article 21, protection of life and personal liberty of our constitution, or some religious argument to the contrary. You cannot take this majority view that a lot of people will be upset. The court has has said that moral indignation cannot be a basis for discrimination.
I agree with you. I agree with you, but remember this one sentence is the correct position. We respect their individual rights. Respect their individual right. Having said that, the whole idea of orientation from a scientific point of view is yet to be proved.
Most
people who are thinking on the scientific line need to be answered on a scientific
the
planet.
The argument
that these
you are not
are
answering,
not
Ashok. Ashok throws the argument at you. Ashok says that in the landmark judgment in July 2009, the Delhi High Court draws a distinction between constitutional morality and public morality. Right? And says that the Constitution's understanding and interpretation of morality overrides
nobody's
any public
denying.
Perception that may disapprove of a certain way of life.
Arnab, let me...
Ashok.
Let me bring this debate... Let me bring this debate
to a
quick
halt. That is true. Nobody is saying... Nobody is denying. We all respect them.
Listen. Ishwar, please listen to me. In France, just a couple of months ago, there was one of the most massive demonstrations against same-sex marriage. Please listen. It is a very fervent Catholic country. It is a Catholic country where the most beautiful cathedrals are there. The clergy is fantastic. But the majority were against same-sex marriage. The French Parliament and the French judiciary upheld the rights of gay and lesbian people to marriage. So you
Father.
See, even if the majority has a problem...
Doesn't matter.
The problem cannot be solved by denying
Father,
us our right.
Father,
the problem can
Father, majority, this basic argument that even if you claim a majority, 99%, 99.9% of the country disapprove of homosexuality.
Exactly.
It will not hold legally, Father. That's what he's saying.
Hold. Yeah, it can't hold.
That's what he's saying, Father.
Yeah. Yes.
Let us wait for the legal things to come out, but our courts can also be questioned with all due respect, contempt of court and all considered. Oh, no. The courts are not giving a... The courts are not giving... The Supreme Court is not giving a decision for the last 8 years on the Dalit Christian issue, which is pending on it and which is purely discrimination based on people because of the religion which the constitution forbids.
No, sir.
But the courts are quiet about it. And no, and your channel or
Father,
no other channel
don't
questions
that, like,
the courts or has a debate on this.
Sir, yes, this
let
case...
Me draw. Let me draw. Let the court... Yeah. Let the
I would
court,
humbly
let
request
court
Father
call
not
me,
to toe that
let
line.
The court call, no.
Father,
wait, no,
don't
wait,
toe the line,
sir. Wait. No, don't tell me what to toe. I am saying you are quoting the court, the Indian courts, the constitution. But the courts are also not taking a decision or not moving forward on the issue of Dalit Christians.
Sir, this case...
Because the Christians, because they
sir,
are
this,
of the religion...
No, no, don't... This, no,
Anir,
Anir is
being discriminated
Anir is saying
against,
something to you from Trivandrum. Anir, to Father Dominic.
No. No, I think we should also... I think first of all, we are discussing right now what the court is... the verdict going to be and that our discussion is on
about
that.
Court.
And secondly, I would just like to add that I think a very good
yes,
example
yes,
is
court,
just next door
I am
is
also
Nepal,
talking about the court.
Which is the only Hindu kingdom in the world which has legalized homosexuality for the last more than 13 years, you know. And I think that is something that we should look upon when we are constantly giving this reference to tradition, science and culture.
And I would also like to add, I would request Father was quoting a totally divisive, communal, different issue, not the court one. But having said that, if Supreme Court goes by this verdict, it's a law of the land, we will all accept.
Absolutely.
But having said that, when discussion comes, these kind of points will come. I request homosexual community to be a bit more tolerant to these questions. Answer it. It's a new thing that is emerging on a public's eye. Let us be real. Let us be realistic and accept it. You know, that's the reason why we are having this debate right now. It's a new thing emerging on the horizon, which was for thousands of years. So, let there be a discussion. It is coming to a big way in the mainstream. Let there be meaningful discussion and not stereotyping of all those people
before
who
you,
raise responsible reservations.
The Indian society prevalent to the before the enactment of the Indian Penal Code. Yes, okay, Ashok, quickly. Quickly, Ashok. Before we wrap up.
I agree.
There were no strictures against homosexuality legally or any otherwise for nearly 3,000 years. There's enough evidence of that from Salim Kidwai's book, from Ruth Vanita's book on same-sex love in India. Ruth Vanita again, Ishwar, has given a very solid documentation to show same-sex marriages in India over nearly 2,000 years. Please do not mock that tradition too. That was a tradition that was not talked about, but it was there. And it was very alive. It was very robust. So it's not that I am not saying that we do not respect the majority. That the majority must also learn to respect a lot of minority traditions too, which are now coming
the
up
judgment,
into the light. If they were in darkness, they were
the
not
The judgment
about,
is on Wednesday.
The judgment does that.
The judgment is on Wednesday. And I do hope and believe that all our panelists today... On Wednesday, as we get you coverage through the day, by the way, we are expecting the judgment sometime in the morning. We're going to debate it that evening on NewsHour. Gentlemen, we all have our right to have different points of view. I thank you so much for participating in this robust debate on the NewsHour tonight.